Welcome to all. Today we are going to discuss purification of colloidal solutions. Here it is, purification of colloidal solutions. Purification of colloidal solutions. How we purify the colloidal solution? Totally two methods are available for the purification of colloidal solutions. One is dialysis and next one is ultra purification. Here it is reason, this is some textbooks they will give ultra centrifugation. Here it is, first we will discuss regarding dialysis. Here it is, dialysis, totally two type of dialysis there. One is normal dialysis, another one is electrodialysis. Here it is, this colloidal solutions what we prepared in normal method or any other technical process if we used. For suppose last class we discussed lyophilic colloidal solutions, we no need to use any separate technique. Simply the dispersed phase we add to dispersion medium, directly we get the colloidal solutions. Those are lyophilic colloidal solutions. Lyophobic colloidal solutions we prepare by using different techniques. Those we are discussing. That is disintegration method, chemical process, Bredig's arc method, peptization. So by using any technique we prepare, that is lyophobic colloidal solution. Normally by mixing DP and DM if we prepare colloidal solution, that is lyophilic colloidal solutions. But whatever it may be the colloidal solution that is present in impure form, that impure colloidal solution if we want to purify, we use any one method from these two. One is dialysis, another one is ultra purification or ultra centrifugation. First we are going to discuss dialysis method. In this dialysis method we take colloidal solutions in a suitable semi-permeable membrane bag, means the bag made with semi-permeable membrane. So here it is, this is the bag that was made with semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane means it contains small holes on this. Like this small holes present, here it is, this is SPM. SPM means semi-permeable membrane. Now this colloidal solution we take into this. So here we are taking one colloidal solution. So here it is, this is the colloidal solution that is present in which form? Impure colloidal solution. Impure colloidal solution means it contains dispersed phase plus dispersion medium plus impurity. These three present in this. Now we has to remove this impurity. That is only purification. So now here it is, we are taking the impure colloidal solution into this semi-permeable membrane. So now here it is, this we are take into the another vessel. We take into another vessel which contains, here it is, water. This is water. And this water also here it is. Inlet, and here we take one outlet. Means water frequently we add and we remove, here it is. So this is the experimental device for dialysis. Once again, listen carefully. The impure colloidal solution we take into one semi-permeable membrane. This bag made with semi-permeable membrane. Into that we are taking impure colloidal solution. Impure colloidal solution means it contains dispersed phase, dispersion medium and impurity. This impurity we has to remove. Now this bag we are suspended into one water contained vessel. Now listen carefully, here we has to understand one point. Here it is. This is semi-permeable membrane, this holes there now. This is the hole of SPM, semi-permeable membrane. Now here it is, this is DP, dispersed phase. And here it is, I am taking, this is small atoms like this present. These are sodium, potassium, like this, any atoms present. Now these are what happen, impurity. These are impurity. So now listen carefully. This is the hole of semi-permeable membrane. This is dispersed phase. These are the impurities. Listen carefully. The size of impurity is very less. But this dispersed phase particle size is bigger than this hole. So that meaning, listen here it is. When we are taken into semi-permeable membrane, this dispersed phase particles can't allow through the void. But these impurities are passed through the void. So meaning here it is, when we are arranged like this, from this colloidal solution, the impurities like sodium, potassium, whatever it may be, sulfur, whatever it may be, small impurities present, those easily pass out through this void. Easily pass out through the voids present in the semi-permeable membrane. So here it is, slowly outside what happen, impurities, impurities will increase. So here it is, like this, finally we get inside DP and DM only, the impurity totally pass out from the semi-permeable membrane. And here it is, this water frequently, if we are not removing, what happen? For suppose, here it is, inside impurities concentration more, outside concentration is less. So that's why here what happen, the sodium potassium ions are coming out through this semi-permeable membrane. If we are not removing water, what happen? After some time, the impurities concentration outside increases and inside decreases. At that moment of time, some impurities will pass into the colloidal solution again. To avoid that situation, we has to add water frequently, we has to remove water frequently. So this is, here it is, this dialysis totally two type, normal dialysis and electrodialysis. Electrodialysis means, normally if we are taken like this dialysis process, it is slow process. To increase the speed, what happen, we put two electrodes outside. Like this, two electrodes we put outside. One is cathode and anode, like that. These two we connected to small voltage. At that time, what happen, this process will become speed up. So that we called electrodialysis. Here it is, the difference between dialysis and electrodialysis is, mechanism everything is same, only to speed up the dialysis process, we take we just pass small charge into that. So due to that charge, what happened, the dialysis process speed will increase. So that we called electrodialysis. Listen here, it is this dialysis process generally doctors they use for kidney failure patients. Listen, here it is, very simple technique here. This is urinary infections. Due to urinary infections, any person is damage of kidneys, at that time they go with dialysis process. And then here we have to understand how the kidneys become get failure means that also. Here it is, if we are not pass urine frequently also, what happen here it is, impurities increases. So when impurities increases in the kidneys, what happen? The impurities again enters into blood. Here it is, listen, it is just imagine as urine, and then if we won't pass out, what happen? Here concentration increases, again it enters into blood. So here it is, this is the dialysis and electrodialysis. Once again, listen, here it is, dialysis process, here it is. First, we have to take impure colloidal solution into one semi-permeable membrane, and then we suspend that into water-contained vessel, and then here it is, what happened? Here, the impurities are passed out through semi-permeable membrane. Why? Because the hole size is bigger than impurities and smaller than dispersed phase particles. So here it is, if you want to speed up this process, we have to use electrodes outside. When we use electrodes, when we are passing small voltages, what happen? The speed will increase, that we called electrodialysis. Dialysis and electrodialysis. Now here it is, I am coming for ultra purification. Ultra purification, very simple method here it is. We take colloidal solution in one container. This is impure colloidal solution. Impure colloidal solution. Into this we arrange one centrifugation fan. We arrange by rotating this fan. What happened when we rotate this fan? What happened here it is, the dispersed phase particle settle at the bottom. Here it is, dispersed phase particles will settle. Here it is, these are DP particles. So now listen carefully, in ultra purification or ultra centrifugation method, here DP particles are separating from DM. And listen carefully, this technique we use for, suppose in this solution dispersed medium there, dispersed phase there, and impurities there. When we are rotating this fan vigorously, fastly, what happen? This dispersed phase particles are settling at the bottom of this vessel, and DM and impurities are present in this solution only. When we go for filtration, this DP solid, what happen, separated from the liquid. In the liquid, dispersion medium present and impurities also be present. That meaning impurities should be dissolving dispersion medium. Then we select this method. And listen, once DP is separated in pure form, then the pure dispersion medium again we take and we mix this DP with that pure dispersion medium. Then we create one purified pure colloidal solution. So this is ultra purification and ultra centrifugation. One more reason here it is, ultra purification or ultra centrifugation method. In this method, we take impure colloidal solution into one vessel and we stir with a highly rotated fan. So when we are rotating this fan, what happens? The dispersed phase particles are precipitated. And the impurities and dispersion medium are present in liquid state. When we go for a filtration, the solid is separated from that liquid. In that liquid, dispersion medium present and impurities also be present. Now, DP we are getting in precipitation means generally by using peptidization process, again we convert this DP into colloidal solution. That meaning we has to use a pure dispersion medium. This DP already purified means we get ultra purified colloidal solution. So these are the two methods are used for the preparation of colloidal solution. So next we are going to discuss properties of colloidal solutions. Next, here it is. Properties of colloidal solutions. Listen, properties of colloidal solutions. In that first one, here it is. Brownian movement. Sir Robert Brown first identified this. So, honor of him, this is Brownian movement. Here it is. Brownian movement, here it is. If we are taken any colloidal solution in this vessel and taking one colloidal solution. This is one colloidal solution. And this colloidal solution I am observing with ultra microscope. When I am observing with ultra microscope, the dispersed phase particles will move in all possible directions. So that movement I observed. The movement of dispersed phase particles in a dispersion medium in all possible directions, that we called Brownian momentum. Once again, listen carefully. When we are taking colloidal solution into a vessel and we observed with the microscope, we observe here the dispersed phase particles are moving in all possible directions. That movement we called Brownian movement. What is the advantage of Brownian movement for colloidal solution? Here it is very simple. If I allow to stand any colloidal solution, the dispersed phase particles will precipitate at the bottom. For suppose I am taking water in a vessel, I am adding starch to that. Starch forms a colloidal solution. But listen, when I allow to stand for a long time, some starch particles gets precipitated at the bottom of the vessel. After that, if I stir with spoon, again some extra starch will dissolve in that water. Again after that, if I allow to stand, again precipitation will increase. So meaning when I am stirring with spoon, the DP, dispersed phase particles concentration in dispersion medium increasing. When I allow to stand, the dispersed phase particle concentration in dispersion medium is decreasing. That meaning the colloidal solution is very effective when I am doing stirring. It is losing its effectiveness when I am allowing to stand. But listen carefully, the solutions in which this Brownian movement is more. Brownian movement more means the random movement of dispersed phase particles in dispersion medium is more. So like that random movement increases, meaning the settling process means when we allow to stand, the precipitation is there, now that we will get less. That meaning the colloidal solution is carrying its effectiveness more and more due to this Brownian movement. Actually, this is when we allow to stand a colloidal solution, The dispersal phase particles are precipitating at the bottom because of gravitational force. This Brownian movement is opposite force to gravitational force. So it decreases the precipitation speed of collider solution and increases the activity effectiveness of the collider solution. So listen, here it is. Here questions they will ask. I'm taking one collider solution at 20 degrees Celsius, 30 degrees Celsius. Where Brownian movement more means it is more at 30 degrees Celsius. That meaning here it is Brownian movement is directly proportional to temperature. Temperature increases, Brownian movement automatically increases. And listen carefully, this Brownian movement is not depends on nature of collider solution. It not depends on nature of collider solution, but it depends on one is temperature and another one it depends on viscosity. Viscosity and listen, viscosity and mass. Viscosity and mass. Listen, lighter is the dp, more is the Brownian momentum. Here it is very simple. Mass decreases, Brownian movement what happen? Increases. And one more here it is. Bigger is the size, then here it is. What is the reason for Brownian movement means? Listen, here it is. In this dispersed phase particles, when moving in dispersion medium, one dispersed phase particles are collide with another dispersed phase particles. That's why here movement is possible. Once again, here it is. One dispersed phase particle, dispersed phase particles are moving in dispersion medium. One dispersed phase particle chance is there to collide with another dispersed phase particles. Due to that collisions, the movement will continue, meaning that collisions more means more movement. When collisions more possible means when size more present, then collisions also be more present, here it is. But listen, first factor is mass, then if mass same, then we choose with size. Once again, listen, Brownian movement. The movement of dp particles in collider solution we call Brownian momentum. The Brownian momentum is possible because of the collisions between dispersed phase particles. It is directly proportional to temperature. It not depends on nature of collider solution. It depends on viscosity and mass. And mass decreases, Brownian movement increases. What is the benefit with this Brownian movement means? Because of this Brownian movement, the settling process of dp particles is become less. The meaning is the effectiveness of collider solution, the presentation of collider solution is very good here. So this is Brownian movement. And the next one is Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect. What is this Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect is very simple. Here it is, general explanation. For suppose when we go for a film, they pass light from projector to screen. When we observe that path of light, some dust particles are moving inside that light. So means that is possible because of the light is scattered on the surface of dust particles. That's why the dust particles are very clear visible to our naked eye. So that is the best example to understand Tyndall effect. The same Tyndall effect is possible by colloidal solutions also. So here it is, I'm taking colloidal solution in this vessel. Now I am passing light through the colloidal solution. So this is the source of light. From this light source, I am just passing light through colloidal solution. So here it is, light is passing light. So now what happened here it is, when light is passing through this colloidal solution, along this light path, we can see some dispersal phase particles clearly. Some dispersal phase particles we see clearly there. So this process we called, this effect we called Tyndall effect. This Tyndall effect is not possible by true solutions, not possible by suspensions. It also be not possible by lyophilic colloidal solutions. It is only possible by lyophobic colloidal solutions. Here it is, why this is possible by lyophobic colloidal solutions, why not possible by true solutions, suspensions, lyophilic colloidal solutions. The requirement here it is, listen carefully, this dispersal phase particle there, na, that size and wavelength of light used, between that, if difference not that much present, then only this Tyndall effect is possible. Here it is, the size of dispersal phase particles and wavelength used for this light, both are very close, then only this Tyndall effect is possible. And one more, refractive indices of this DP and DM present with very difference. The difference between the refractive indices, difference between DP and DM is very high, then this Tyndall effect is possible. For suppose refractive indices means the outcoming light wavelength, the difference, this DP and DM both present, both are visible, means here we can't observe DP and DM separately. So here it is, reason, two conditions must and should for Tyndall effect. One is the size of DP particle and wavelength used for the light, both are comparable, then Tyndall effect possible. And the second one, the difference in refractive indices between DP and DM is much bigger, then we seen this Tyndall effect. The two characters are possible by lyophobic colloidal solutions. So that's why here it is, this Tyndall effect is possible by only lyophobic colloidal solution. So here it is, Brownian momentum, and here it is Tyndall effect. And next one here it is, next effect is coagulation. Next method is third property, electrophoresis. Electrophoresis. This is, here we are discussing properties of colloidal solutions. In that first one, Brownian movement we discussed, second one Tyndall effect we discussed, and the last one electrophoresis. By using electrophoresis we prove colloidal solutions contains charge. Here this electrophoresis gives proof for charge on colloidal solutions. Colloidal solutions, positive colloidal solutions and negative colloidal solutions we discussed, that charges we prove by using electrophoresis. Listen, in this electrophoresis we take one U-shaped vessel. Here we take one U-shaped vessel here we take one reservoir. From this reservoir we fill colloidal solution into this. So from here to we fill colloidal solution into this. So like this we are filling colloidal solution in this U-shaped vessel. So when we fill colloidal solution in this U-shaped vessel, and in this we arrange electrodes here. Here one electrode and here another electrode. Here it is cation and anion I am using, cathode and anode I am using. Listen carefully, if you are taking NaCl, this become Na plus and Cl minus. This Na plus is cathode and Na plus is cation and this is anion. Cation attracted by cathode and anion attracted by anode. That meaning cation contains positive charge, cathode contains negative charge. Anion is negative charge, anode is positive charge. So means it is anode and this is cathode. So now this anode and cathode I am connecting to external battery. When I am connected like this, electrodes to external battery, what happened? First suppose here it is, this colloidal solution if contain positive charge. If this colloidal solution contain positive charge, your negative electrode present, the positive colloidal solution is attracted by negative electrode. So means now precipitation I get at negative electrode. Negative electrode means at cathode. For suppose if colloidal solution contain negative charge, that negative charge particles attracted by positive electrode and forms precipitate on positive electrode, that is anode. So means if you are getting precipitate on anode, so means anode positive charge means colloidal solution contains negative charge. For suppose I am getting precipitation on anode means, on cathode. If I am getting precipitation on cathode means the colloidal solution contains positive charge. Once again here it is, this is positive charged electrode, that is anode. Negatively charged electrode, that is cathode. I am getting precipitation on positive terminal. Positive terminal means on anode I am getting precipitation, means colloidal solution contains negatively charged. For suppose am getting precipitation on negative electrode. Negative electrode means on cathode. Means colloidal solution contain positive charge. So plus precipitation coming means negative charge. Negative area of precipitation coming means positively charged. So by using like this electrophoresis method, we give the information regarding the which charge present on colloidal solution. Either that is positive colloidal solution or negative colloidal solution. And one more here question, they will ask direct format like this, and another format here it is. For suppose I am getting precipitation here. I am getting precipitation on negative terminal means on cathode I am getting the precipitation. Means what happened? The liquid moves in this direction. Means this side level decreases, that side level goes towards electrode. For suppose precipitation coming this side level decrease. So how level decreasing? From this we send again colloidal solution into this. So question they will ask, for suppose level this side decreasing like this they are showing, means precipitation coming here. And level decreasing this side means precipitation coming here. Which side level less? For suppose listen here it is, anode side level of colloidal solution less, meaning the precipitation is coming at cathode. Cathode side level of solution is less, meaning the solution, the precipitation coming at anode. So this is electrophoresis method. So by using electrophoresis method, we give idea about the charge on colloidal solution. And the next one is, next property here it is coagulation. Coagulation. Here it is. What is this coagulation? Listen, this coagulation process, this is reverse to peptidization. What is peptidization? Precipitations we convert into colloidal solutions. Here colloidal solution we convert into precipitation. Here very simple. Here it is, one colloidal solution I am taking. To this I am adding one electrolyte. Electrolyte. Now this colloidal solution, for suppose this colloidal solution is two types. One is positively charged colloidal solution, another one is negatively charged colloidal solution. If our colloidal solution is positively charged, means from this electrolyte it attracts negative charge and gets precipitate. And if our colloidal solution is negatively charged, it attracts positive charge from this electrolyte and gets precipitation. So here we get precipitation. This phenomena only we call as coagulation. Once again listen here it is. In peptidization process, for precipitates we add electrolytes to convert them into colloidal solution. But for that same colloidal solutions, electrolytes if we added excess. In peptidization process we add very small quantity of electrolytes. But listen, for colloidal solutions, if we added more and more quantity of electrolyte, positive charged colloidal solutions attract negative charge from electrolyte and gets precipitation. Or negatively charged colloidal solutions are absorbed positive ions from electrolyte and gets precipitation. That precipitation process we call as coagulation. And here it is, listen, in this from this coagulation process, they ask coagulation power and coagulation value. Coagulation power and coagulation value, listen here it is. Coagulation value and coagulation power. Here they will change the question, simply small information we have to concentrate. Coagulation value and coagulation power. coagulation value means here it is, actually we had totally colloidal solutions, two type of colloidal solutions we had here it is, lyophilic colloidal solutions and lyophobic colloidal solution. Between DP and DM attraction present, these are lyophilic colloidal solutions. And here it is, lyophobic colloidal means DP and DM attraction not present, those we called lyophobic colloidal solutions. But listen, here it is, lyophilic colloidal solutions and lyophobic colloidal solution, these lyophilic colloidal solutions are stable. And listen, this preparation very easy, separation also become very easy, but listen carefully, they are stable. Why? Because they are stable means between DP and DM attraction present more. Here students, they confuse simply, sir, preparation easy, you are telling separation easy and stable. Listen carefully, lyophilic colloidal solutions, when we allow to stand, they will give precipitation, but immediate shaking they will form again, colloidal solution also. So listen, that's why their preparation easy, and we can separate DP and DM, and we can prepare again colloidal solution easily. So that's why preparation, separation and stability, all are preparation easy, separation also DP and DM easy, and then they are stable. Why they are stable means, just you take dispersed phase and add to dispersion medium, immediately they form colloidal solution. And lyophobic colloidal solution is there now. Those are preparation need special technique. So here it is, between DP, dispersed phase and dispersion medium, there is no attraction. So we are creating attraction by using special techniques. So that's why these are less stable. These are less stable. So now here it is, lyophilic colloidal solution and lyophobic colloidal solution, we can, these are less stable and these are stable. But these are less stable, once we prepare the colloidal solution, we can't separate DP and DM. That's why you won't say those are more stable. Why? Because any method by using, we are separated DP and DM. Listen here, DP, DM separation not possible means by allowing to stand without disturbing, if we allow to stand for a long time, DP, DM will not separate out here. But by using special techniques, we can separate here also DP and DM. But once separation over, again by mixing DP, DM, we can't get again colloidal solution. Again, we have to use special technique. So that's why we can say this is less stable, this is more stable. Listen once again, this stable point is give some little confusion to you. So again I am explaining, lyophilic colloidal solution preparation is very easy. You take dispersed phase and dispersion medium and mix well, and then we get the lyophilic colloidal solution. If we allow to stand, precipitation will come. But once you shake it again, you get the lyophilic colloidal solution. That's why we can say this is stable. And here it is, between dispersed phase and dispersion medium, attraction not present. That's why preparation need some special technique. So that's why we can say this is less stable. Here, once lyophobic colloidal solution prepared, dispersed phase, dispersion medium, we can't separate by using normal methods, means by allowing to stand for a long time, we can't separate here it is. For that purpose also we have to use special techniques. That's why we can say this is less stable. Here it is, when we are adding electrolytes to these colloidal solutions, for suppose here it is, a lyophobic colloidal solution is there. That lyophobic colloidal solution or lyophilic colloidal solution, to improve the that settling process, I am adding electrolyte to this. When I am adding electrolyte to this, colloidal solution is getting precipitation. How many milligrams of this electrolyte required, that we called coagulation value. Here it is, number of millimoles of electrolyte required to complete coagulation in 1 liter colloidal solution we called coagulation value. This coagulation value is equal to number of millimoles of electrolyte by volume of colloidal solution in liters. So that is coagulation value. For suppose here it is, listen, question type I am giving to you. Here it is, 1 liter colloidal solution required 6 moles of electrolyte, calculate coagulation value. Very simple, that is 6 by 1, 6. Number of millimoles, so 6 by 1, 6. Here it is, what is coagulation power? Coagulation power means, here it is, I am taking one colloidal solution. I am using electrolyte A, I am using electrolyte B. So a particular colloidal solution, for a particular colloidal solution, I am doing coagulation process by using two different electrolytes. Electrolyte A, electrolyte B. It required some 6 millimoles and it required 4 millimoles. So, which coagulation power is more? This is the same colloidal solution. For same colloidal solution, I am using two different electrolytes. One electrolyte required 6 millimoles, another electrolyte required 4 millimoles. So, where coagulating power is more means, here coagulation power is more. That meaning, where coagulation value is more means, here coagulation value is more. So, means coagulation power and coagulation value both are inversely proportional. Once again, listen, here it is, coagulation value is equal to number of millimoles of electrolyte by volume of solution in liter. Here, listen carefully, here millimoles means here ml you take. Millimoles means ml. Here mole means here you take liter. Okay? Millimoles to milliliter, moles to liter. So like that you take. Here it is 6 moles liter. That's why 6 by 1, the answer is 6. So listen, here it is, coagulation value means the millimoles of electrolyte required to complete coagulation in 1 liter solution. So here it is, what is coagulation power means? Listen, where coagulation value is less, means there we can say the power of that electrolyte is more. So means here it is, in this experiment I am using B 4 millimoles, A 6 millimoles for same colloidal solution for same volume. So means it is more effective electrolyte. That's why for this electrolyte coagulation power is more, but coagulation value is less. Here coagulation value is more, coagulation power is less. So this is, here it is, coagulation process. And here it is, in this coagulation process only gold number is there, that we will discuss in tomorrow class. Thank you.